So here we have our most well-known portrait of Richard.
It's quite interesting, isn't it? Because it's quite different to some of the other ones, like the very famous one in the National Portrait Gallery. And this one's quite a different image, isn't it?
It really is. When people come and look at the portrait, we get, you know, visitors that specifically request to see him. I think they feel a sense of looking at the real person. His body isn't a costume that's kind of reflecting that Thomas More, William Shakespeare impression of the villainous king.
Yeah.
He's got these beautifully slender hands. He's playing with a ring on his finger, which kind of enhances the fact his hands are so anatomically well rendered. And he's got only a very slight sense of an unevenness to the shoulders. But when people come to see this picture, they do always comment that it seems like a very true representation of the king.
And it's one of the ones that hasn't had so much overpainting, isn't it?
Yeah, it underwent conservation work a few years ago, and as a result of that, conservators discovered that the hairline at the shoulder had been slightly adjusted, and there'd also been overpainting to the top lip.
Mm.
But what you're looking at as a result of that conservation work, conservators worked to take that overpainting back. So what you're looking at now is as close to the original portrait as we have.
And for this project, the really interesting thing is that it's one of the earliest portraits of Richard, isn't it?
Absolutely. It's considered to be a copy of a prototype produced during the king's lifetime. The dendrochronology gives us a ballpark figure of 1510 to 1540. Mm. So we know that it comes from a tree felled not too long after
yeah.
the king died. But it's thought to have been copied from a portrait that was produced when he was king.
Mm.